supporting men's health for Movember this week on The Wire. Aussie homes again the biggest, consumer and business sentiment rises, and mortgage deferral numbers drop. G'day guys, my name's Tim Guest and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate. We can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment and more. Now please like, comment and share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. So let's kick it off with our top story for this week. So Aussie homes again the biggest. So Australia is again building the biggest houses in the world, and that's after several years of shrinking. And that's according to data commissioned by ComSec from the Australian Bureau of Statistics. Now the average new house built in financial year 2020 was 236 square metres, and that's up 2.9% on the previous year, and the biggest increase in 11 years. Now the ACT is building the biggest houses in Australia. That's ahead of Victoria, New South Wales and Western Australia. ComSec Chief Economist Craig James says that before last year, Australia had been building progressively smaller houses on average, having lost the title of the world's biggest houses in 2013, because he says Aussies had embraced units as well as smaller houses. He also says the size of the average house built in 2019 financial year was the smallest in 17 years. While we built bigger homes in the past year, the big question is whether the decade-long downward trend has ended. And COVID may play a big role in answering that question. So the average size of a unit also rose, up 6% over the year, hitting a decade high of 137 square metres. Now guys, for our next story, consumer and business sentiment rises. So businesses are the most confident since 2019, and consumer sentiment has lifted to its highest level since the pandemic began. And that's helped by the end of Melbourne's lockdown. NAB's monthly business survey showed the confidence index lifted in 9 points in October, the highest in over a year and above the neutral level, indicating more optimists than pessimists. The business survey is the latest evidence that Australia's post-pandemic recovery has taken hold. NAB Chief Economist Alan Oster says the improvement in confidence is encouraging but remains fragile and will likely remain that way until a vaccine is available. The upbeat business survey follows the news that the ANZ Roy Morgan's weekly confidence measure lifted to an 8-month high and above the neutral level for the first time since the health crisis has struck. There was a 10% surge in the meter gauging whether it was time to buy a household item, which ANZ Head of Australian Economics David Plank says could signal a buoyant Christmas shopping period. Now guys, for our final story of the week, mortgage deferral numbers drop. So the NAB says the number of mortgages in COVID-19 deferral has fallen significantly as more and more borrowers return to making their monthly payments. At its peak, NAB offered deferrals to 110,000 home loan customers. But at the end of October, 75,000 loans are no longer in deferral. The NAB's deferred mortgages are now total 34,000, worth $14 billion and less than 5% of NAB's total loan book. This follows recent announcements from other big banks showing reductions in deferred numbers. Westpac revealed 31% of its deferred customers had requested a further 4-month extension, while the Commonwealth Bank advises it has 41,000 or 20% of 210,000 loans still being deferred. The ANZ reveals around half of its home loan deferrals have come to an end, with 95,000 customers initially deferring. The NAB reported a 37% fall in its full-year cash earnings to $3.7 billion, caused by rising expenses, mounting bad loan provisions, and income pressure from record low interest rates. Well, guys, that's it from me. They're the top stories for the week. Now, please don't forget to like, comment, and share this video, and follow or subscribe wherever you're seeing this. Have a great week, guys, and remember, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference. That's action. Thanks a lot. Bye for now.